When you enter my entrance hall, this display is the first that you see. So, all bottles. There are all bottles from different World War II dumps. And you see there on top, there are some Belgian beer bottles. All World War II related. The second is very interesting. There are all a lot of cola bottles and lemonade bottles. This one is from the First World War. And on this side you see some cola bottles. So in this one, this cola bottle, a little bit damaged, but that's a German Coca-Cola bottle. And I hope you can see it. This German Coca-Cola bottle is from 1936. You see it there? 1936 is well before the war. Next to it is a very early Fanta bottle. Fanta is a brand that still exists. And this one is from 1940, you see? Very early in the beginning of the war. And it's the original invented by the Germans, who didn't get any more of the Coca-Cola syrup from the United States in the beginning of the war. So the next one, that's a Belgium Coca-Cola bottle. This one is from 37, also a very early one. And there behind, some US bottles, Coca-Cola bottles. All from the 44-45 period. And this one is also a very interesting one. That's a brand called Cola Nada. You see it, Cola Nada. From beginning of the war. Very special bottle. And there are some other regular bottles. Next drawer are some medical bottles. All some same shape. Here are some beer bottles from the same period, from the brand Sester. Three different types, brown glass. Oh, very beautiful. And this one I love. These are all ink jars. You see a lot of different shapes. And as you can see, there are some still with the ink in it, like that one. Yeah, I love it. And in the lower drawer is some snaps bottles, different sizes. Wow, we did find them a lot. And one side of my living room, you have this display. Small display, but a beautiful display. And on the left side, two US helmets. They are together. They are stick together. This one is a very nice display. It's a RAD, Rijksarbeidsdienst display. All dinner plates and cups, coffee cups. Marked RAD, see there one, Rijksarbeidsdienst, and in the front of it, a couple EKM's, erkenningmarken, and belt buckle, and two cap badges, and this one, they are, you find it in the same dump. Names from RAD soldiers, and I think these were labels from their closets. Yeah, and there on the backside, Adolf Hitler, there are Adolf. That was a nice find. This was from another place, but very nice find. Second drawer, some big shrapnels, special shrapnels, there on the backside. You see some two big, nasty shrapnels.
in the partially exploded shell. Some big parts of driving bands, and also nice to find. You see there, scrapnel and a bullet. A little bit closer, and the bullet embedded in the woods. There another scrapnel. Lower, some bayonets. First one is a British spy bayonet, and German bayonet, US bayonet, and fighting knives, US fighting knives. And in the lowest, some nice bottles, very different shapes. Here on the right side, a beautiful German helmet from a couple years ago, very good condition. And here in the top, some personal hygiene stuff. You see there, razor blade, shaving brush, shaving cream, toothbrushes, and dental cream, spoon and fork, part of a knife, and of course our hair comes. The next drawer, some small arms, two old revolvers. I don't know if they're war related, but they were found on some kind of battlefield. Very small pistol and a magazine. I think it's from a Colt 45. And in the back side, yeah, you know that US pineapples, empty of course. This one is also interesting. All dog tags, EKMs or Erkenningsmarken, German Erkenningsmarken. A lot of them, well, we did find already a lot of them. These are all, I hope I can zoom in on one. You see, they're all RAD, Reichsarbeitsdienst. These items were coming from an abandoned temporary US airfield. In the back are some parts of gun camera film. The rear one are for photos, and they are from the film. In the front, three moisture plugs. They were for the get the moisture out of the cylinders of the engines from the airplanes. Oh, they are very special. Now this is the central cabinet with on top of it the spare bottle from MG42. And in the first drawer, a lot of medals. The most of all German medals. Bundesabzeichen. And some cabbages here. There on the right some cabbages. This one is the DRM Sport medal. There the small one, that's a beautiful one, that's Edelweiss from the Gebergsjägers. Next to his Infanteriesturmabzeichen. Some wounding badges. A cross. These are two SA Sport medals. The other very nice. That's one from the submarine attack. Another Sturmabzeichen. This one is a British one. Yeah, I'm very proud of it. It's my only British one. Here in the front, some other small ones. There's a Russian star. Get back to some skills from the Panzertruppen. Some other cabbages. The next one, a lot of belt buckles. There are some special one there, like this one. That's from the Hitlerjugend. A little bit busted, but okay.
This one is a steel one from the SS.
And in the front, some other parts of belt buckles. Buckles. This one is also a special one. That's a SR belt buckle, copper one. I like that one. I like that very much.
A little bit lower. Some EKM's, Erkenningsmarken, German dog tags. Complete one, half ones. This one is a special. That's one from the Kriegsmarine, but I think it's self-made. Because it not, that's not the standard form. Here's another one. You see here, that's the standard form from the Kriegsmarine. A little bit smaller than the army one, you see there on the back side. And again a little bit lower. There on the back side, and a very nice belt buckle with part of the belt on it. The blue one is Winterhulswerke. A lot of buttons. Some rings, a couple gold rings with it. Some other Winterhulswerke. And this one is interesting. That's the cap badge from World War I, First World War. But I don't know which country, which army that it is. Please, if you know it, please let me know. I appreciate it. Then in the lower, some canteens. First one is a US one, then a British one, then two German ones. The one on the right side that is from the desert. It's completely covered with cork. So the cork was a good isolation against the heat from the desert. That one I like very much. Yeah, this camionette I love very much because there are a lot of special items in it. So I am very proud of it. On the other side of my living room, this beautiful cabinet with all medical bottles. Most of them came from the same dump. You can see it on one of my videos. I love this cabinet. Here on the top, the small bottles. The front row is the very small bottles. The most water purifying bottles. You see, the small bottles are from a different dump. But on the rear side, see this one is still with some contents in it. Very beautiful bottles. There, the second one. Some bigger bottles. This is also very interesting. Some kind of test for, I don't know, test tubes. Different color, different letter writing on it. And you see, still some fluid in the bottles. This one is also interesting. Glass syringe. With some cups. Some bigger bottles. All with some contents in it. Yeah, there. Still some contents in it. Here on the bottom one. See some big bottles. And in the front. This very beautiful, complete, full Baxter bottle. And on the left side and the right side. Some complete bottles with aspirins. I think the US soldiers eat aspirins like candy. There are a lot. There another big bottle there. Yeah.